Welcome to the 7th of December. It's Monday, and I'm sitting here working on something so tiny. It's actually hard for me to knit and talk with you at the same time. And, well, I have to put it away because I will show you something. This is, yeah, here you can see it. It's pink. It's very light pink. And, oops, it is going to be a little mouse. I'm sitting here with a green mitten. Only one. I have only one. And a little mice family. Family of mice. Do you say mice family or mouse family in English? I know that the plural of mouse is mice. But a family is not plural, so I'm not sure. But here you see 5 mice. And they have found a house in the green mitten. When I was 20 years old, I was working in a preschool, a daycare, kindergarten here in Trondheim. I was an assistant. At that time, it was in 1979, it must have been. 79. I was 21. And in the kindergarten where I worked, we were 2 grown-ups in each group, 20 children and 2 adults. And I was an assistant, and I worked half of the year in one group with one group, and then the other half of the year with another group. And the leader, the teacher, she was very creative, and she challenged us to be creative as well. And when she knew that I could, I loved to make things with my hands, she talked to me about the fairy tale or story of the mitten. Here in Norway, we call it the green mitten or the fur mitten. And she asked me if I could make the mitten and the animals belonging to it and tell the story to the children. So I made a mitten out of fur, and I tried to draw the animals and could put them up on a wall when I told the story. When my children were small, I remembered this and I wanted to make something for them. We had a Norwegian book then, which is called The Green Mitten, Den Grønne Votten, The Green Mitten, by a very famous Norwegian, well-known author, Alf Prøysen. He's dead now, but still I think all children in Norway, well, if they don't know his name, they know his stories and his songs and his lyrics and so on. And he has written this book about grandma knitting a pair of mittens for her grandson. And he's out. He's making a snowman, and yeah, it's a long story. I'm not going to tell it here, but he loses one of the mittens, and he's very, very sad, of course. And a family of mice finds the mitten, and they moves in, and well, in the end, he finds the mitten and can show his grandma very proudly that, oh, I've not lost it. I think that Alf Prøysen, the author, has been inspired to write this from a fairy tale from Ukraine, which I have here. Skinnvotten, which means the fur mitten, or the leather mitten or something. The fur mitten, I think. Which is about a green mitten, which is lost out in the forest, and a lot of animals moves in, starting with a little mice. And then bigger and bigger animals are coming until the very last one, which is the bear. And they spend the night in the mitten, very warm and cozy. But then they can hear the man who lost the mitten is coming, and they fleed out. And when the man, or maybe it's a boy, picks up the mitten, he says, "Oh, it's still warm. That's strange, because it has been out in the snow all night." I talked about this here on YouTube a couple of years ago, and I also blogged about it. And then one of my followers told me that there is also an English or American book about the mitten by Jan Britt. I think the American viewers here know Jan Britt. I think she's famous. She has written a lot of children's books. And I found the book on Amazon and I bought it. And it's also a beautiful tale based on the same Ukrainian story, fairy tale. Here is a boy, his name is Nicky, and he asks his grandma to knit him a pair of white mittens. You can see white mittens here. And the granny says, "Well, maybe I should knit in colors, because if you have a white one, it's very, very easy to lose it." Here, the mitten is lost. But the boy says, "No, I want a white one." And the granny knits a pair of white mittens. And Nicky is out in the forest. And of course, he loses one of the mittens. And here also, animals start to move into the mitten, starting with a mole, and then bigger and bigger animals. And here, well, it's a very cute one here, the fox moving in. So the white mitten is filling up with animals, the bear. But then the mouse comes as the last animal, and she squeezes into the mitten, and her whiskers is tickling the bear. And he, what do you say with "acho"? Oh, I don't remember the English word, but "acho," says the bear. And all the animals flew out of the mitten. And Nicky has been out in the forest searching for the mitten, but he couldn't find it, obviously, because it was white and the snow is white. But because of this "acho," the mitten flies up in the air and Nicky can find it. And he can proudly go back to his granny and say, "I haven't lost them. I love my white mittens and I still have them." I love to read this book for our grandchildren. After last winter, I put them away because they are winter books. But now I have found them again. And when the two oldest grandchildren will come here on Saturday, and then we will read them. The youngest one, Vida, is too small yet. So I still have, well, in this book by Alf Prøysen, it's a mouse family moving into the mittens. So that's why what I have made. One green mitten and a mouse family. But this Alf Prøysen, he has also made a very funny kind of Christmas song. It's not a Christmas carol, but it's a children's song about a mouse family, with the granny starting to tell her grandchildren, the small mice, that you have to be careful for the mouse trap, and if you're careful, we might be able to celebrate Christmas again. And they have they don't have a Christmas tree, they have an old shoe. And the granny has a rocking chair, which is obviously a huge potato. So what I'm working on now, it's to make knitted items and crochet items for this Christmas song. I asked my daughter, the mother of Leander and Milian, the two boys, if she had some worn out winter shoes from the boys, but she hadn't. She had given them away. Or thrown them away or something, I don't know. So I decided I will crochet a boot, and I will crochet the potato, and I will decorate according to the children's song. And then I will put this decoration out in the greenhouse. And when Christmas comes, I can take the grandchildren out there and we can play with the mice. So that's what I will be working on today, to make a few more mice and then also start crocheting the boot and the potato. I will, of course, show it to you when I'm finished. I'm sitting here with a Santa mug. Yesterday was Sinterklaas, St. Claus Day, which I forgot to celebrate. So I'm celebrating a little late today. Terje still has his work done from home because of the corona. And when I was preparing this filming, he was down in the kitchen making himself some coffee. He asked me if I wanted some, but I said no, I will make myself a mug of tea when I'm ready for filming. And then when I came down to make the tea, he had put two Christmas cookies for me on the counter. They both types are made by Terje. I haven't started to bake yet, but I hope to start maybe today or tomorrow. This one we call brown sticks. And here is gingerbread. So I will enjoy these now, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye!